Hello everyone, may God bless all of you, may He bless you, may He bless you in your family, in your friends, wherever you are, wherever you go, that people around you be blessed through you, through the conduct, through sincerity, and you honor the Word of God, and God's Word will also honor you. If you sow by honoring God and living the Word of God, then the Spirit of God's Word will also honor you and wherever you go, because this is God's will, that His holy name be sanctified through our lives, much more than to be worshipped. Because one thing is for you to praise God, moved by a heart that is by emotions and feelings, right there at the church, in that spiritual environment, or that clean environment with music and hymns, and you surrender to that worship and praise to God. And this is important. But when we leave the church and we go back into facing our life, or going through the problems in life, it is different. Because the Lord Jesus, I believe, this is how I think, what He wants is for His name to be sanctified through our lives here on earth, than to be, or for us to be praising Him in the church for some time or for some hours. Because that worship has a value, a great value. But we have to honor God 24/7. And that is only possible when we honor His Word. When we are true, when we take on a character of God here on earth, taking the steps of Jesus, our steps, meaning walking just as He did. And that, dear friends, is only possible when we have the Holy Spirit, when we have the Spirit of Christ, for he is the only one that can lead us into the truth, nobody else. And if a person does not have God's Spirit, the Apostle Paul, guided by the Holy Spirit, says he is not his. He who does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not his. This is important. And that is the reason. This is the reason why many, they start well in their journey, and along their path, along their journey, the battles and deserts, they end up giving up, running away from the desert. So they lose, they lose their contact with God. People know, everyone knows, I believe. People know and confess, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Yet, if they put on paper, write on paper their whole life, they will notice that they are lacking everything, and is lacking especially peace. They have lack of money, there is a lack of things, they lack children or husband, wife, parents, they lack jobs, they lack this and that, lack many things. And when you believe in the Lord Jesus, when you truly believe in the Lord Jesus, then it's a must. A person needs to have peace. They need to have peace. There is no chance for a person to believe in the Lord Jesus and do not have God's Spirit. It is not a theory to believe in theory or religiously, or to believe just to live for a couple of hours or Wednesdays or Sundays. No, this belief must be 24/7. 24/7 and throughout one's whole life. And that is only possible when a person has and led by the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ. And when King David made this prayer guided by the Holy Spirit, this prayer is the Holy Spirit. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures." So missing nothing, lacking nothing. He leads me beside the still waters. This is peace. But who does this? Who is this Lord? It's the Holy Spirit. He was given him the task to guide and lead those who believe in his Son. "I will ask the Father, and the Father will give you another counselor. I, the counselor, will go to the Father, but I will ask in my place, I will ask the counselor to guide, who is the Holy Spirit, and he will lead you into all truth." And when a person has the Holy Spirit, when they are taken, possessed, sealed, baptized with the Holy Spirit, then the Holy Spirit is the one who leads them into green pastures. He says, he leads me besides the still waters. He makes me to lie down in green pastures and leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Not the air conditioned for the body. The Holy Spirit restores one's soul. The soul that is thirsty of peace, the thirsty that is in need of peace, that soul that is anxious to have peace, the soul that wants a moment or desire a moment, just at least for a moment of peace. But Jesus He doesn't give a moment of peace. He says he makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He leads me beside the still waters. When a person has the Holy Spirit, they don't live in sin. They make mistakes. All of us make mistakes. All of us, we fail. If we do not make a mistake in our words, we do wrong in our thoughts. If we don't do wrong in thoughts, we do wrong when we speak or our actions or in weaknesses. We are always having faults and mistakes. Yet, the Lord, the Holy Spirit, He leads us and convinces us of our sins. And if we hear His voice and obey, so then we say, Lord, forgive me. Forgive me. Lord, forgive me. And He forgives. Every single day, in the morning and in the evening, I pray, Our Father who is in heaven, my Father who is in heaven, sanctified be Your name. Your kingdom come, and Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give me today's Friday. What do I need for today? So today, give me Friday. Give me what I need today. Give me today what I need. And what is for tomorrow? Tomorrow, You will provide. But what I need for today is the daily bread. Forgive us. Forgive me of my sins, my mistakes, my debts, as I forgive those who debt against us, those who betrayed me, those who offended me, those who badmouth me, those who are aggressive or hate me. Forgive them, because they don't know what they are doing. I am following the example of Christ. He is the one to follow. I'm following His steps. And that is to sanctify the name of the Lord here on earth, because in heaven, His name is exalted and made great. But here on earth, His name is scratched off. His name is despised. His name is insulted because of the wrongdoings that people who call themselves Christians, who are the worst, because when a person that they are not Christian, they believe in nothing, it is easier for them to believe, to truly believe, than the ones who know of the truth, but continue in their lies. They know Jesus artificially, but they continue living in lies. And unfortunately, this is the truth. Therefore, the Lord is my shepherd if the Holy Spirit is with me. If I do not have God's Spirit, then He is not my shepherd. And that is the reason why many Christians from all the churches, in the universe of all Christian churches out there, in their majority, they know Jesus or they know about Jesus, but they do not know him personally. And why? Why they don't know him personally? Because they did not receive the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Christ, and only he, only the Holy Spirit can reveal, can present to us the Lord Jesus, and nobody else. Only the Lord Jesus Christ, he can reveal his Son, the Savior, the Lord Jesus. And this comes with the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And that is the reason. It is the reason why this coming Monday at 3 a.m. it will be during the night. It will be the video in pajamas, the video in which you do not need to come to the church. You don't need to move from your place, from your home, from your workplace. You don't need to move. This video will take place between you and God. There'll be no one by your side. It is you and God. I will be here through all the means of communication, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Universe. We have this platform, which is Universe. And right there on Universe, the app, we have the content of faith. The movies in this platform, that is nothing to do with faith. Everything is with faith. It's a channel that is only dedicated for people who are Christian and those who want to hear God's word. They want to meditate. So Universe is a tool that will be broadcasting this video live to everyone all over the world. Wherever you are, have access to Universe to watch the broadcast of this video Monday at 3 a.m. Brasilia time. The time of Brasilia at 3 a.m. Brasilia time of Monday in Brazil will be, I believe, in some, let me calculate here, it will be 4 hours less in Europe, in Africa, 5 hours ahead. So, the hours may change completely in Central America, the US, all over the world. We will be broadcasting this video. And you can be, you can have or you can dress any way you want. Dress the way you are, because it will be between you and God. And the interesting part is that no one will look at you. It will be you and God. Only God will see you, because you will find, look for a spot where you can be by yourself with God. I know that some bishops of the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God will make this video as well, personally, in the church. They will hold, because the time is during the day and the possibility for people to join. So be free. You can do you can take part at work, in your house, in the hospital, in prison, wherever you may be, because we will have also the radio stations available, broadcasting, not only the radio, but universe, well, where we are going to broadcast this video 3 a.m. this upcoming Monday. So then, prepare your heart. Because without the Holy Spirit, it is impossible for you to be of God. It is impossible to be saved. It is impossible for you to be saved. Jesus himself said, interesting, he said that the kingdom of God is like a man who found a treasure, an incalculable treasure, precious treasure. Then he hid that treasure, returned to his house and sold everything he had. He sold everything, put everything together and sold it to buy that field that he found, the treasure. And this treasure is the Holy Spirit. Once you receive, then God himself, through the Holy Spirit, will guide you into green pastures, will guide you to still waters. Only he can do that. And he does not only do this, but he will also restore your soul that has been sad, abandoned, because of the battles that you have on a daily basis. So the Holy Spirit freely, you don't need to deserve in order to receive him. You don't have to pay to receive him. Of course, you must seek, you must go after, you must show that truly you want to have communion with him. You know, when we get married, the spirit of marriage is love, is God. When a marriage is of God, so God's Spirit keeps that marriage. But when a person is interested in being with God, marrying God, like our Lord Jesus, it is the Holy Spirit that matches us with our Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And from the moment that you receive the Holy Spirit, the person has assurance, has peace. They believe tomorrow. They believe that tomorrow God will be taking care of them just as he has today. David, guided by the Holy Spirit, said, "The Lord is my shepherd." So the Lord is God, is Jesus, is the Holy Spirit. He is the Father, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Holy Trinity, inside of a person, within a person. And he, as one God, and he guides us and leads us to green pastures. He leads us to still waters, and he will restore one soul. He will make our soul happy, in peace, and joyful. The battles and problems will continue, but inside, there is that assurance. The assurance, the conviction, that he cares for us. Jesus said it. And then, David also says, continuing, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, he walked in the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. So the Holy Spirit is with us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The rod is to catch one's attention and to guide, not this way, that way. And much more than that, he says, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. So God honor his word. He honor his servant, his child, with his presence. So you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and you anoint my head with oil, and my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy of God shall follow me all the days of my life. Meaning, not even one day will be missing, all days. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah. Friends, the Holy Spirit, he is the one who leads. The Holy Spirit led David. And the Holy Spirit lead all those who want, those who truly and with sincerity, they want to serve him as instrument in his hands. Friends, the Holy Spirit, he is the potter, and we are the clay. And he mold us. He mold our life according to his will. And when we depend of people, so then what can we do? When we lose signal, we have to wait. But regardless of what happened, Monday, we will have our vigil. Get ready for our vigil for this Monday, for you to receive and be filled with the Holy Spirit. You will be by yourself. You will be alone, you and God. You will not see God, but God will be seeing you. You will speak to God, and God will hear your prayer and will answer you in that moment. Monday, 3 a.m. Brazil time, together in this great vigil in pajamas. God bless all of you, and until tomorrow, in Jesus' name, amen.